Tuesday, September 25th. It is now 7:20 a.m. somewhere in America. And as we look outside, beautiful countryside. Of course, the sun is shining, the sun is rising on this side, so let's go to breakfast. Had breakfast. Now let's take a walk to the observation car. Coffee. Here's something neat. Every sleeper car gets get coffee and water and ice. Oh, and also orange juice. Somebody decorated this car very nicely. This car has been refurbished, as you can see. It's got
Hey, good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Better lighting.
In about 10 minutes, we'll be arriving at the next station.
There we go. Come into Minot. So coming into Minot, North Dakota, this is a refueling stop. We'll be here for about half an hour, so an opportunity to get off the train and look outside. So we'll do that. I'm going to get some officer readings in, and then we'll go take a look outside. North Dakota. It's a bit brisk out here. Danger, hazard, and train present extreme hazard. This is a refueling stop. We're in car 731 right there. Well, that's where we're at. Looking over yonder. It's a half hour refueling stop. Around. Here we go, Minot, North Dakota. You are here. Let's go inside the station. This is quaint. Closed. That's not a good sign. Oh wow. Book rack. Isn't that neat? Exchange your books here. That's what somebody else said.
We copied them.
Yeah.
All it is a copy. There's no fancy.
Yeah.
This is our.
Yeah, that's a copy of.
Yeah, because I got the electronic version, but you know what? As a computer geek, you know what? Paper is still faster. So.
Well, that's the thing is, if you go to Amtrak.com on your smartphone, you can look at the same thing without killing a tree.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, just like for future reference.
Yeah. There you go. Thank you. I got that. That's the Minot, North Dakota train station. There's the Empire Builder. From one end to the other. It is a bit nippy out here. Wow, this is my first taste of cold. Oh yeah, here we go. 30. miss it. Sleeping car, wait, a sleeping car in the back of the train, okay. The back of the train, actually, this is actually two trains. They split it, because when we get to Spokane, they split the train south of the dining car, and I think, and then half of it goes to Spokane, the other half goes to Seattle, so. Catch it. It said 39 degrees. Let's see if I catch it the next time around. I'll re-edit it and put it in the right place. This video brought to you by Tempur-Pedic. Don't miss it. And Sealy mattresses. 820 and 39 degrees. That's what they call bracing. Let's take a walk back. Shot for Alan. I don't know if he's putting all the electrical connections there, equipment room, utility room. He's going a little bit faster than we are.
Yeah.
That is weird. That is so weird. What? Wait a minute. We are achieving relativity. We have achieved relativity. Ah, look at this.
Oh, good. I got it.
And now we're going a little bit faster. Look at that. That is so cool.
Green, horn on top.
Yeah. Greener. Now we're going. We should be passing the engines again.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, have your attention, please. As we depart the Mile High North Dakota this morning, I would like to take this opportunity to welcome everybody on board the Amtrak Empire Builder. Folks, we're going to be experiencing some rough track throughout the day.
Rough track.
Why are they pointing the finger at us?
We'll be right back.